minus t plus 2, according to our rule, we need to shift the time reversal signal towards right axis up to 2 times. So shift. After drawing the right shifted version, the signal will be confined from where to where? Anybody? We are going to shift this towards right. Why? Because as per our rule, x of minus t plus t naught, it should be shifted towards right side by 2 units. So the signal will be confined to from where to where? From which time to which time?
Minus 1 to 3.
Yes. So same shape you are going to draw from minus 1 to 3 after shifting the signal towards right side by 2 units of time. So we are plotting x of minus t plus 2. So the same shape, it will be coming like this. So again, the signal will be confined from minus 1 to 3, because when you shift this towards 2 units right side, this plus 1 will become 3, this will become minus 1. So this will become 0 and this will be 1 and this will be a 2. So this is a signal that you obtained after shifting the same signal towards right side by 2 times or by 2 units of time. Please remember these amplitudes and all, it is going to be same. This is, what is this value? This is negative 1. So this is x of minus t plus 2. Let it be figure number 2. Figure number 1 is your question. Figure number 1 is, it is x of t. Now you need to add this figure 1 and figure 2. Kindly draw figure number 1 again, x of t. Then you draw x of minus t plus 2, and that you need to add those two signals one by one. So figure number 1 is nothing but your x of t, which is given in your question. That is coming like this only. This was your given signal. Now you need to add figure 1 and figure 2. While performing the addition, you need to go for time slot basis. So from which end you need to come? From which end you need to come? You need to start from the leftmost end, that is nothing but negative 1. So negative 1 to 0, if you focus the time minus 1 to 0, this is the signal that you are getting over here, whereas here this is like this. When you add these two, what will be the answer? Anybody?
So zero.
It is zero because there are two symmetrical waveforms of opposite amplitude. One is of amplitude 1, the other one is of amplitude negative 1. So if you add these two parts of the graph, the answer will be 0. So if you take this interval minus 1 to 0, you don't have any signal, or you need to plot an x-axis itself. Now coming from 0 to 1, here you have 1, here you have 2. So when you add these two, your amplitude will be 3. So from 0 to 1, you have 3. For 1 to 2, here you have 2, here you have 1. Again, 2 plus 1 is 3 itself. So from 1 to 2, it will continue towards 3. Again, from 2 to 3, this is like this, and this is like this. Again, these are two symmetrical signals of amplitude negative 1, and what is the amplitude of this? It is plus 1, isn't it? This is plus 1. So if you add this as well as this, then it will cancel out. Again, the signal is 0, it will come back. So during 2 to 3, it is 0 itself. Then do you have anything to add from 3 to 4? You don't have anything from 3 to 4, 4 to 5 till infinity. You don't have any signals at all. So if you add, the signal is nothing but 0 itself. So this is the added output, that is x of t plus x of 2 minus t. Let it be figure 3. So this can be labeled as figure number 3. We want this later. Kindly draw till this. If any doubts, please feel free to ask. Now, as of now, we have completed this much portion. Now, you need to go to the next term, u of 1 minus t. So, I will be rubbing figure 1 and figure 2. Students, I need your feedback. Are you able to follow me? Any doubts, please don't hesitate to ask. Okay, at any time you can ask. Please put a message in Google Classroom so it can be visible to all other people also. So don't feel shame to ask. Even if it is wrong also, it is okay. I'm there to support you. I'm there to clarify the doubts. Okay. No issues. At any time you can ping me. Even if in WhatsApp also, if I'm there in the online means, I'm there to clear. Okay. Otherwise, you can put in the classroom. I'll be checking and I will clarify the doubts. Now, the third part of the equation, it is u of 1 minus t. So, you need to draw that graph. The main thing is that you need to respond, because since this is online classes, everybody is having difficulties, isn't it? From your side also, some net connections will be there. I mean, net issues will be there. From here also, you can have some power issues. We can have some net issues. And all. But the thing is that there should be some compromise. Okay, so parallelly you need to respond. Okay, only then I will be able to take the class. Unless you respond means the subject is not at all interesting. If you are responding means I can't make this understand to you also in a better way. Okay, so kindly respond to all those questions what I am asking. So now you need to draw for u of 1 minus t. So to draw u of 1 minus t, what you need to draw initially? Krishnaind, to draw u of 1 minus t, what you have to draw first?
U of minus t, sir.
Yes.
U of t, then u of minus t.
Yes, very good. First you need to plot u of t, then you need to plot u of minus t, then you need to plot u of minus t plus 1. Very good. So first we will plot u of t, which is very familiar to you. That is nothing but the unit step function, whose amplitude is 1. Next thing is we will be plotting u of minus t, which is a time reversal function, and the amplitude is still at 1, but it comes towards the negative side. And the next thing is, you have to be very cautious about the next thing, u of minus t plus 1, to which side you will shift.
Right side, sir.
Yes, right side by 1 unit of time. As a result, it is starting from plus 1 towards negative axis. So this is the step that you have. The step is starting from 0 and it is approaching towards negative infinity, but the same step I will be shifting, starting from plus 1 towards negative side. Okay, so this is the step that I have drawn, and the amplitude is still at plus 1. This is your figure number 4. This is figure number 4, and now what you need to do is, you need to multiply figure 3 and figure 4. We need to multiply figure number 3 and 4. Kindly do the multiplication again. That time slot basis, same concept only. So first I'll start from which time? I will start from which time? Minus infinity, because this has got value still minus infinity, right? So till minus infinity to 0 it is 1, but this 1 you are multiplying here with what? 0. You don't have any signal till 0, so 1 into 0 is 0. So till 0, from minus infinity to 0, you don't have any signal at all, because 0, here it is 0, 0 into 1 is 0. Now coming from 0 to 1, here you have 3, here you have 1, so 3 into 1 is 3. 3 into 1 is 3. And from 1 to 2, here also you have 3. But unfortunately, here you don't have anything starting from 1. So in the rest of the places, 3 into 0 will become 0 itself. So this is the final plot that you have. That is nothing but y of t, which is equal to x of t plus x of 2 minus t multiplied by u of 1 minus t. So this is the final graph that you have. Any doubts, students? Okay, I will do one more problem and then I'll stop the class. Okay, one more problem, kindly note, because this is a vast subject. So we need to finish, because already this is 13th class. Okay, but I'm not able to finish module 1. Actually, it is time to start our second module. Did any other subjects started module 2? Sayan? Any other subjects?
No, sir. Everyone is still in module 1.
Okay, thank you. Okay, fine. Okay, one more question you take down. Two continuous time signals. See, kindly practice all these questions. Okay. Take one rough note along with the lecture note. You write those questions again and again. You practice, because without practice you won't be able to score good marks in the subject. There will be plenty of careless mistakes in between. Even if you know the approach, even if you know the methodology, still you won't be able to get into the final answer. I can see while evaluating You can see many answer sheets like that. Okay, they will be knowing the concepts, they know the approaches and all, everything, the formula, everything they know, whatever the integrations also they know. But the thing is that because some minus will become plus, some positives will become negative. So because of these things, the error will occur and final answer will be wrong. So for the steps only, you will get the marks. Okay, so kindly, please be cautious while doing all these problems. Two continuous time signals, x of t and y of t are given below. Two continuous time signals, x of t and y of t are given below. Draw the signals. So this is the graph for x of t and y of t. You have given two different signals and you need to plot set of t which is equal to x of 2t multiplied by y of 2t plus 1. So what are our mathematical operations we need to perform here? Anybody can say the type of operations we need to perform here? Logesh Biswas. Logesh Biswas, kindly tell what are the math? Yeah, what are the operations we need to perform here?
Amplitude scaling.
See where there is amplitude scaling.
Time scaling.
Yes, very good. Time scaling.
What time about the scaling and time shifting?
Yes, time scaling, time shifting, and finally multiplication. Time scaling, time shifting, and finally multiplication. Very good, very good. Now, first thing what we will do is we will be plotting x of 2t. Hope you have taken down. Now you will be plotting x of 2t. So whether the signal is going to be a compressed signal or expanded signal. X of 2t is nothing but your time.
A compressed signal.
Yes, this is going to be a compressed signal because you are multiplying t by 2. The factor is that multiplication factor is greater than 1. If it is less than 1, like 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and all, then we need to expand that. So since here we are multiplying the time axis by a factor greater than 1, we need to compress the signal 2 times. So while compressing the signal, what will happen is this 1 will become half. This one will become half, this will become 1, and this will become 1.5. Isn't it? 3 by 2 is 1.5. So, draw the signal, same shape you need to retain. Same shape you need to retain. But the time axis you need to change accordingly. This is x of 2t, what I am drawing now. So this will be a compressed signal. Same shape I am retaining. There is no change in amplitude also. Amplitude will be minus 1 here. Here it will be plus 1. But this will be at 0.5. This will be at 1. This will be at 1.5. Again, this will be at a minus 0.5. So the signal has been compressed half, that is now it is confined to negative 0.5 to 1.5. So let it be figure number 1. This can be considered as figure number 1. So we have done with this. Now coming to the next part, you need to draw y of 2t plus 1. So how many operations are there in y of 2t plus 1? In y of 2t plus 1, you are having two operations. One is time scaling and second one is time shifting. So according to the precedence rule, which one you need to perform first and which one second? Tell me, which one you need to perform first? Check the precedence rule once again.
Sir, first shifting and then scaling.
Okay, first shifting and then you need to perform scaling. So first you need to perform shifting and then you need to perform scaling. Please note it down. This is the precedence rule. First you need to shift and then you need to scale. Otherwise the answer will be wrong. So first you are going to shift y of t plus 1. First you are going to draw y of t plus 1. So this is y of t plus 1. While drawing y of t plus 1, to which side you need to shift?
So left.
Yes, it is left shift. So this will become 3, this will become 1. If you are shifting towards left, it means you need to subtract minus 1. So the entire signal will be confining from minus 3 to 1. Minus 3 to 1. Same shape, it will be confining from minus 3 to 1. This is correct. Check with your answer whatever you have drawn now. This is your y of t plus 1. You have shifted the entire signal towards left side by 1 unit. So this minus 2 will become minus 3. This will become at minus 2. This will be at negative 1. And this will be at 0 and this will be at 1. So this is correct. After shifting, you need to perform scaling. The scaling is y of 2t plus 1. Again, you need to compress the signal. You are required to compress the signal. Because you are multiplying the time axis by 2, that value is greater than 1. If the scaling factor is greater than 1, you need to compress. If the scaling factor is less than 1 or if it is a fraction, then you need to expand. Please keep it in mind. So, the signal whatever we have drawn in this, we are going to compress between what? This will become minus 1.5 to 0.5. So, same signal I am going to draw, but it will compress like this. So this will be your figure 2. Okay, draw till this figure. The amplitude and all it is same. There is no change in amplitude. So kindly mark the amplitude. plus 1, minus 1, there is no change in amplitude. The only thing what you have done is you have shifted to the left and then you have scaled by 2 or compressed by half. Now check figure 1 and figure 2. You need to multiply these two. So kindly multiply by time slot basis. Take each and every time slot separately and then you do the multiplication and let me know what is the answer. So first we will focus from minus 1.5 to minus 0.5. Okay. First I will focus from minus 1.5 to 0.5. Are you able to hear my voice, students? I'm not getting a response. Sayan, is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just I need to multiply it and redraw the final answer. What I will do is, I will rub the two graph and I will be focusing these two. Okay. These two I will focus and I am going to multiply. So first take the time interval from minus 1.5 to 0.5, minus 0.5. Here from minus 1.5 to minus 0.5 you are having plus 1. But here there is no singularity 0.5, so this is 0. So 1 into 0 is 0. So you don't have any signals till minus 0.5. It will be in x-axis itself. And later, coming from negative 0.5, you can see here at negative 0.5, you are having a ramp. This is ramp. What is the equation for ramp? What is the equation for ramp? Nirmit? Nirmit is there. What is the equation for ramp? No response. Lavanya, what is the equation for ramp?
Sir, y is equal to mx plus c.
Ramp equation is R of t equal to t. Ramp equation is, see, you have to reverse ramp t. It is R of t is equal to t. So as you can see, this is a negative ramp, isn't it? This is coming from negative axis. Clear? This is in negative y axis. So this is a negative ramp. And again, this is also something which is negative. Coming to the second figure also, it is in this shape. Again, this is negative. This is also t, but in different slopes you have. So when you multiply these two, what will happen? When you multiply these two, minus t into minus t, it will become a positive t square. Can anybody tell what shape of graph you will get after multiplying minus t and minus t? I will repeat, minus t into minus t is plus t square. A signal which is a function of t square is which shape? A signal which is a function of t.
Sir, it will be positive slope.
Once again, I didn't get you.
Sir, it will be positive slope, no, sir.
It is positive.
Like minus t into minus t is plus t square.
Yes, plus t square. But in what shape? You won't get in the same ramp shape itself.
Parabola.
Yes, very good. Parabola.
Parabola, sir.
Yes, parabola. Yes, parabola. And what will be the amplitude of that parabola? What is the amplitude of that parabola if you multiply these two?
One, sir.
It will be one. Okay. Okay, fine. So, from 0.5 to 0. From 0.5 to 0, you are getting a parabola like this. But what will be the amplitude of this signal? It is not one. You just think once again. Because at a zero, it is coming towards zero, isn't it? Here at a time, you are having negative one. Here at a time, t equal to zero, you are having zero. That is
point
why zero
five,
one is zero. So at the starting point and at this ending point, the value is zero. But what about the amplitude?
So will it be 1/4, sir?
Yes, very good. It is 1/4 because this amplitude is half here, isn't it? Again, here also it is half. So half into half is 1/4. That is 0.25. I'll tell you once again, please. I think you have only 2 minutes left. Anyway, I'll tell you once again and tomorrow I will repeat. Okay. See, you have a waveform like this. Here its amplitude is -1. Here it is 0. So in between, at this particular point, you are having -0.5. Similarly, in above graph also, you are having like this graph, isn't it? What is the first graph? Yes, it is like this graph. Here also you are having 0. Here also you are having -1. So the middle amplitude is going to be -0.5. So this -0.5 and this -0.5, when it multiply together, it will become +1/4. It will become +1/4. So the amplitude has now become 0.25. Now come to after zero. Is there any signal after time t equal to zero? Come to 0 to 0.5 case. During 0 to 0.5, you have 1 in both cases, isn't it? No, one is one, and what is the other signal that you have? T. This is T, isn't it? The other one is having 1. This is having 1. So 1 into T is again T. Clear? We just checked the two graphs, figure 1 and figure 2. I have already rubbed that figure 1, so I'm not able to show it. You just check in your answer sheet, I mean your rough note, lecture note, figure 1. How does having during 0 to 0.5, what is the signal that you have in figure 1? Can anybody please respond? From 0
sir,
to
it's
point,
a ramp, sir.
Yes, it is ramp. So that ramp, when you are multiplying with 1, I think you are having 1. In y of 2t plus 1, you are having 1, right? So this plus 1 into t will become...
Yes, sir.
Yeah, plus 1 into t will become t only. So it will go like this. So it will go like this and its amplitude will become 1. Now, this is still half, that is 0.5. After 0.5, do you have any signals to plot? There is no signal in y of 2t plus 1. If you consider y of 2t plus 1, after 0.5, you don't have any signal at all. That is, it is 0. So 0 into any factor will become 0. So it will come back to the x-axis. So this is the final plot that you are getting. This is nothing but the product of, what is that? The two signals, x of 2t into y of 2t plus 1. Okay. Please check once again, after 0.5 you don't have any signal in x of 2t, but in y, I mean any signal in y of 2t plus 1, but in x of 2t you are having some signal, but don't bother about that. When you multiply any signal with a zero value, final answer will be zero itself. So ultimately the signal will come back to the x-axis and it will prevail over an x-axis itself. Is this clear for you? This is very important question. Please mark it as important. So I will stop at this point. Already I have shared the attendance link of first hour. I mean from 150 to 250. From 250 to 350 class, I will be sharing the link now itself within 5 to 10 minutes. Kindly mark your attendance. Okay. If any doubts, please let me know. You can put it in chat box, or you can ask, unmute and ask. Okay, thank you all.